All right. Welcome back, everybody. It's Sport Chat 503. Well, thank you guys very much for watching. First time, long time. Either way, I appreciate it. Trying to break it all down here from Portland, Oregon. You know, we go live here on Sundays, people. This is the day to break it down. Rankings come out. I try to go through them. This one's talking about the college football top 25. And, of course, if you're talking top 25 in college football, you got to start with Bama, 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 Bama. You know, now that Bama's got a quarterback that's mobile and that can do pretty much anything and is a Heisman Trophy candidate, can't you just say right now Bama wins the whole thing? I mean, come on. This is getting ridiculous here, people. They already get the best players. Now they're getting the best quarterbacks. Now what the heck are you going to do? They get Arkansas. Big deal. I mean, are you serious? I mean, come on now. Okay, Georgia. Georgia, you know, Tennessee put up a fight. Great. They play Vanderbilt. Next, Georgia, Bama. Again, just sign it up. Maybe Ohio State makes it interesting this year, huh? They played Penn State. This was a huge game, huge game. This is pretty much going to decide the Big Ten because Wisconsin took that loss to BYU. They would also take the loss to LSU at this point. Ohio State, man, this is, again, one of those deals. What would have happened had they lost? If they lost, would they have been like 10, 12, or would they have been like 6? People love Ohio State. They want to make Ohio State as great as they can because they need that representative for that Big Ten. Not impressed. Yes, they have a good team. Yes, they're good athletes, but I'm just not impressed. I'm not impressed with Herb and his whole situation. It leaves a bad taste in my mouth. So, you know, I was kind of rooting for Penn State there. Sorry, but I kind of was. I'm okay that they lost because I don't know if you're gonna have Penn State in the top four because you probably would have had that jammed down your throat too, but it is what it is. Ohio State can be there. Clemson did not look good. Had to come back to beat freaking Syracuse. Now Syracuse did beat Clemson last year, so it's not surprising. And Syracuse has looked better this year as well, but not good. So they took a step back. LSU, you know, they crushed Ole Miss. They look good. They play Florida at Florida. That could be interesting. I think they're going to crush Florida. The Florida looks like absolute butt cheeks. And then if you really break this thing down, Notre Dame had the biggest weekend. Notre Dame got to play a quality opponent and just stomped on them. Stanford wasn't even close this game. Notre Dame was awesome. They play Virginia Tech next week. It's going to keep rolling. It's just going to keep rolling. Oklahoma, you know, they crushed. I can't believe Oklahoma almost lost to Army. That blows my mind. That absolutely blows my mind. But they crushed Baylor 66-33. That's just insanity. They play Texas. That could be an interesting game. You never know what happens with the old Oklahoma-Texas game. You never know. Throw out the record books. Auburn. Auburn looks good. Auburn, you know, they're doing their thing. They're going to play Mississippi State. I think they're going to drill Mississippi State. But Auburn, they could make some noise, and they could be somebody that they have to look out for. LSU and Bama. I did get to watch the West Virginia game. I think West Virginia looked real good. They beat the heck out of Texas Tech. I tend to think West Virginia is for real. And if you're over there on that side of the Big 12, you can make some real noise. Because I don't like the rest of the Big 12 outside of Oklahoma. I guess Texas is a little bit coming back a little bit, but I think West Virginia's in it for the long term here. We'll see what they can do against Oklahoma. Washington at 10. Gotta have it. They play at UCLA. They'll probably crush Chip Kelly and the boys down there. And then we got a matchup at Autzen for Washington. I think on that one, Washington might win. I think Oregon could win. About as on the fence as you can get there. I don't know if Oregon will beat Washington, but I think it'll get close. Nittany Lions, see, they lose, and then they're right at 11. So, you know, they would have been in the top five if they had been beating Ohio State. Played a good game. Now they get to play Michigan State. We'll see how that looks. I think Penn State's second-best team in that conference. And that is saying something. The Big Ten is good, but I don't know how good they're going to be when they go up against other conferences in the bowls. UCF, they're undefeated. They're still doing their thing. Whatever, we'll see at the end. I'm really happy with Kentucky. Kentucky's 5-0. Feels great there. What a great story. Kid on my high school team went to Kentucky, set records down there, went to the SEC Hall of Fame, got inducted last year in the Hall of Fame under Hal Mumme and Mike Leach. They set records down there, and they haven't been good since. I mean, it's been that long. Kentucky, I always have a soft spot in there for that era, the 90s, and what they were doing at Kentucky in late 90s, 99, 98, 2000. Stanford takes it on the chin big time, but they only drop back a couple spots. You know, Stanford's a good team. I think they'll be in there to the long haul. They got that win against Oregon that was crucial, but I think they're a pretty good team. I think they'll be there. Michigan gets there. They got Utah. Stanford's got Utah, which is a very tough team, I think, coming in. But I think Stanford can win. Michigan, though, Michigan had a tough time against Northwestern. Unexpected a little bit. Now they got to play Maryland. Could be tough. You never know. Maryland beat Texas. Texas is looking better. You know, you play that little college football game. After Michigan, you've got Wisconsin. Wisconsin beat Iowa, but not crazy. You know, 28-17 is a blowout, I guess, in that division, but didn't look great doing it. Now they get Nebraska. Nebraska's been absolutely terrible. Scott Frost is blaming his players. I mean, it is getting horrible over there. Miami beat North Carolina. You had to have that win. You get Florida State. I think Miami's going to hammer Florida State. Florida State's been awful, although they did get that win. You know, and then the Ducks. Huge, huge time for the Ducks. They're top 20. They got a bye week. Then they got the big game against the Huskies coming in. They're sitting pretty right now. Get healthy. Get right. Then get your big game and win one of them. You got to win one of these big games. They got these two on the schedule this year with Stanford and Washington. You got to win one of them, Oregon. Texas plays Oklahoma. We talked about that. I kind of like Texas' chance to hang with them a little bit, but then Oklahoma's going to win by about 4 touchdowns. Michigan State, you got Sparty in there. Sparty had a little trouble with Central Michigan. Didn't blow them out the way they thought they were going to. I watched part of that game. And then they get Northwestern. You never know about them, but Northwestern looked pretty bad this year. The Buffs are in the top 25. They play Arizona State. I think Arizona State can win that game, and then I think Arizona State might find themselves in the top 25. I think Washington State could be in the top 25 as well. I like Florida a little bit up here, even though I think Florida's going to get beat by LSU. You got North Carolina. You got Virginia Tech. And I think Virginia Tech, and they're going to get beat this weekend. And then you got Oklahoma State. Oklahoma State, they're doing their thing. Of course, they lost to Texas Tech bad. Then Texas Tech just lost. So that didn't look good for them. But they're up. They play Iowa State. You never know what happens against Iowa State. Weird stuff, so. All right, guys, thank you guys for watching Sports Chat 503 Top 25 Review. All right, see you next week, people. Adios.